The stuff between the two commas here is extra information, and the main meaning of the sentence is that in the year 1933, approximately 30 major kidnappings were reported in New York City, more than doubling. See, introduction of a present participle after a comma leads to a cause-effect relationship. Is there a cause-effect message here? No. Just that kidnappings were reported does not double anything. So choice A can be eliminated. Similarly, choice B also, because of this two more than double, sounds as if the reporting led to the doubling of number, or as if that the reporting was done in order to double the number. That's not the case. The message is very simple, that the number of kidnappings reported this year, as in 1933, was more than twice the number reported in any of the previous years. So B can also go. Look at choice C. What is this those referring to? Those is referring to kidnappings here. And see, the comparison is between numbers. The message is that 30 is a number which is more than twice the number reported in any of the previous years. You can't compare a number with kidnappings. You can compare number of kidnappings with number of kidnappings. So C can also go. A very important concept this. Between D and E now, E has a flaw, as much as. See, much is a term that would come for quantities, for numbers or figures, countables. Many is the right term. Had it been as many as, we would have thought about this answer choice. Right now, this can be comfortably eliminated. Let's confirm choice D. In the year 1933, inspired by something that's extra information, approximately 30 major kidnappings were reported. So, kidnappings were reported, and these 30 kidnappings were more than twice. And the buzzword, the most important term here, is the number. This phrase ensures that a number is being compared with another number. So, 30 major kidnappings were more than twice the number reported in any of the previous years. D is the correct answer choice.